One day, God, I'm getting ready for a match against Jack Swagger, and all of a sudden I go, I can't move my neck at all.
Hey guys, I am here at Battle Arts Academy in Mississauga, Ontario, doing a little catch up with everybody's favorite guy, Santino Marella. Come on in, come here.
Santino Marella.
Awesome, awesome. I'm fantastic. I've been blessed with a wonderful life after wrestling.
Honestly, I'm actually really excited to get to pick your brain on everything today because it seems like you're really doing things right up here.
Yeah, man, I kind be careful what you wish for. We do a lot. So, I mean, I knew the clock was ticking, so I started preparing Battle Arts. Battle Arts is really actually three different places in one.
Okay.
This is Battle Arts Academy right here. This is where we do our grappling, we do submission wrestling, Olympic wrestling.
What is this rolling around happening over
Those
there?
Are my judo students over there. I'm the judo coach now.
You are?
I stepped away from judo for, 13, 15 years as I was wrestling. And then when I retired, I'm officially back in judo. And I got a whole team of young competitors over there training. Now give me like a Sayatoshi and put on an arm lock. And then boom, booyah.
Damn.
Don't break it. Yeah. So we have three Olympic sports, wrestling, judo, and boxing. And then we do the MMA side. And of course, we have professional wrestling. And then in the middle here, we have the Don Koloff Arena.
Oh, okay.
So as a part of the education here for the professional wrestlers, they gotta wrestle in front of a live audience.
Yeah.
Because a lot of places when you wrestle and you leave, you have no experience working in front of people.
Right.
So here, concurrently, we have our shows, we bring our friends and family, we watch the tapes back, we critique it, and that kind of stuff.
How many people can you fit in here when you have shows?
We've had up to 500,
but
that was uncomfortable.
Oh.
I'd say 300 to 400 we can do really comfortably, yeah. So we have the strength and conditioning side over here where we do weights and we do Olympic weightlifting, we do functional training. We have professional wrestlers here from Israel,
yeah,
from France, from Germany, from Australia. It's becoming a little bit of a hub for international guys that want to kind of break into North America. And we have world-class kickboxing coach, like world champion, world-class boxing coaches. It's like an all-star coaching staff.
Your name again is what?
Santino Marella.
What was it like walking out there and winning the Intercontinental Championship the first time?
Oh my God. I definitely wasn't living in the moment.
Yeah.
Because I was just
freaking
terrified
out
of not screwing up something. It's crazy, man. The audience was crazy. My dad is an immigrant from Italy, and I was able to say that I was from his hometown.
Where are you from?
San Fili Calabria.
So it was a perfect opportunity for me to just get in touch with my Italian side. I learned the language.
Wait, you fully learned the language?
I'm not fluent, but I was enough to go cut a promo in Italy. This is how it happened. It's actually funny. I had a cassette tape. It was for tourist Italian.
Yeah.
So I used to listen to it in rush hour traffic on a daily basis. So when they called at the time and said, hey, are you really Italian? And Dusty Rhodes taught me, if they ever ask you if you can do anything, the answer is yes.
Yeah.
So they said, can you speak Italian? I'm like, yeah, yo, yeah, right? But all I could say was that tape. So they say, okay, say something in Italian. I'm like, vorrei un mezzo chilo di formaggio, which means I want a half kilo of cheese.
I guess.
That sounded Italian.
Yeah.
And they're like, okay, yeah, we'll call you, it sounds great. And all of a sudden, the next day, I'm flying to Milan to potentially debut as this character. So, of course, I go to, the bookstore and I buy these DVDs. I'm, drinking espresso on the plane, listening to all the Italian, trying to absorb everything I could. You know, a little fraudulent.
Dude, sure.
We're gonna see it! The Cobra! The Cobra strikes! The Cobra strikes!
Give me the history of the Cobra.
Well, I was living in Japan for 1 year, and that's where I trained the original Battle Arts with Mr. Ishikawa. One of his friends, Taro, he wanted to show me this thing that he transforms his arm into this little puppet thing. It's like a puppet.
Yeah.
And I remember saying, okay, looked in the, well, I don't get it, what is it? And he goes, no, it's just a funny thing. And then fast forward 5 years later, I'm on the road, I look at Cena. This is a live event, so it's not TV.
Right.
So it's like bam, 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 and to a roll up. And the audience immediately laughed.
That's awesome.
And I came back and he just gave me the wink and goes, keep that.
As a matter of fact, it's... It's a Christmas cobra, Kobe!
And one day I go to Rod, Vince wants to see the cobra. And I'm like, he heard about the cobra? So I did it on TV, and that's it, man. It caught on. It caught on to a point, I remember when I'd make that face or like the gesture that here comes the cobra.
Yeah.
And I would see in the corner of my eyes, like the audience standing up and cheering. I'm like, I don't get it. Well, it's funny, but it's not like, you know, they love it. They love it.
Yeah, loved it. You've had such an amazing career. What ultimately led to your retirement?
My neck was compromised from the start. I actually injured it in university. So whatever disc moved back a bit, it was kind of hitting my spinal cord, and it started calcifying and becoming like a piece of bone.
Oh, gosh.
We had to get a double cervical fusion.
What is that?
Well, there's three vertebrae, and they take out the discs, and they put in pieces of cadaver bone, and actually shin bone. From some, I believe it was a dead Russian guy.
Stop it.
I don't know how I got there.
No, it was not.
It was a cadaver, cadaver bones from a shin bone. Because shin bone is similar size to your vertebrae, and it's very strong. A few months later, two screws came out. WWE took awesome care of me, flew me out the next day, surgery. And then at this point, it was a wait and see game to see if it's ever going to get well enough to come back in the ring, which was our goal.
Yeah.
And it just didn't.
I'm going to ask my question in the form of a rapping song.
Now I'm healthy and it is vital. I want back my IC title. Yes!
I didn't know I was going to be funny, but, you know, when I meet people, they're like, thank you for making me laugh.
You have a big mouth, John Cena, and there's nothing I would like more for Christmas than a chance to shot it.
In the beginning, of course, I wanted to be a tough guy, but
sure. Put
the ego aside, and I wholeheartedly took the role and ran with it.
Just your relationship that you have with the WWE Universe is a really great relationship.
It is. It's different. It's very different from everybody else's, where you got to leave them wanting more.
Yeah.
And Santino always left them wanting more.
Yeah.
I never won the big one. And there's something romantic about leaving it that way and coming so close. I mean, literally a one count away.
Yeah.
From becoming heavyweight champion.
Yeah.
And people come up to me and I'll meet them, and this is years later when, we were standing and jumping. Even Mick Foley said that he was in his living room with his family jumping up and down, screaming at the thought that I was about to win it. And having those memories and coming so close and being known as the guy that we always wanted a little more from.
Sure, what a great spot to be in.
I love it.
What are you most proud of in here?
I'm proud of the fact that everything has grown proportionately.
Yeah.
All the programs are growing. This place is actually it's a collection of things. Like, the rings are like from Santa Monica, Beach of California.
Oh, cool.
A little bit of OVW.
Yeah.
And all these different things that I saw along the way. And I said, you know, if I ever have a place, I'm going to have that there.
Yeah.
So we put it all together. So it's like my dream facility. I miss being on the road. I miss eating at Denny's with my friends, and now being on the road every weekend, I don't see myself being able to do it.
Yeah.
I've committed to these kids, you know, and I gotta coach them.
Yeah.
One of the fun things I do in my class, everyone has their own nickname.
Okay.
Everyone. We got Scorpion, we got Dragon, we got Punch, we got Hollywood, we got Neptune. We call him Neptune because his judo's out of this world.
Oh, yeah. Snap.
It's the personal development of the kids, you know.
That's awesome.
You see them identify themselves with, like, I'm a winner.
Yeah.
And that's what I want.